What's up, everyone, and welcome to the club. In today's video, creating an epic sketch illustration of Phantom Foxy from Five Nights at Freddy's. Now for today's lesson, we're sketching on plain white sketch paper and a black 4B pencil. Let's use the side grip and sketch with the flat edge. Starting in the middle, let's sketch out a circle to define the size of the head. Starting from the very top, just gonna lightly work our way around the left side, and then bring that back in towards the middle, and then go over towards the right side. Now from here, we're going to add some guidelines to help with the symmetry of our drawing. Let's start by sketching a line coming down the center, starting from the top of that circle. I'm going to bring this all the way down towards the bottom of our page, and then back up towards the top. Now let's add another guideline on the side of our circle, going up towards the top, and then down. Do the same thing on the right. Now you want to add two more guidelines, one going across the center of our circle, from left to right, and then one along the bottom. Now from here, we start blocking out the key features of the head. From the center, we're just going to curve this out, and then down towards the left and right side. Let's bend this back out towards the side of the muzzle. And then round up the muzzle, and just pull that back in, just up above the bottom edge of our circle. Let's go to the center of the muzzle and sketch an oval going around the left side, then over towards the right. Now let's go to the side of the nose, curve this out, and then down towards the bottom of our circle. Now from here, we're gonna add those two points along the side of the head. Let's start from the left side of the muzzle. I'm just gonna curve this out and up toward that center line, and then line this up on the right. And I'll bring these points back in towards the side of the head, coming in and up, just rounding out the inside. Let's go back to the side of the muzzle and draw the lower jaw. Starting from the left, curve this out, and then in, almost like drawing a large bracket. And we'll curve this back in and then down towards the bottom of the jaw. Let's round out the bottom, curving down and up. Now I want to go back and trace the jaw along the outside. So we're going to step out, just leave an even space gap all the way around towards the chin. And then we'll round out the bottom. Now from here, we're going to move back up and draw two large circles for the eyes on either side of the muzzle. So let's start on the left. Pull this in, around the top, and then back in. And we'll do the same thing on the right side. Now let's add a guideline for the center edge of the ears. Starting from the top of the eye, angle this up and out towards the tip of the ear. Go over towards the right side, angle this up and out. Now we want to go up towards the same height. Let's draw the inside edge of the ears. Starting from the tip, curve this in, and then down toward the top edge of the head, and then do the same thing on the right. And go back to the tip and draw the bottom edge of the ear, coming down, and then in. Now you want to open up the right side of the head. From the top of the right eye, step in, draw a straight line going all the way up toward the top of the head. And then from the outside of the eye, go straight out. Let's flatten off the bottom of the right ear. Starting from the top, just angle this down and out. Now you want to add a small bump along the top of the head, starting on the left, going up in the middle, and then back down. And then add those hairs along the top of that bump, starting right in the middle, curve this up and out towards the left, go back to the center, go another curve going out, and we'll add one more. Going back to the center, curve this up and out towards the right. Let's go to the center of the right eye, sketch another circle for the iris, and add a smaller circle right in the middle. Now from here, we're going to go back and take out some of these guidelines, starting with the outside, and we'll take those lines across the center of the head. Now from here, we're going to add a second level of detail. Let's start with the top row of fangs, starting right in the middle. Angle this down and out towards the left and right, and we'll pull that back up underneath the muzzle. Let's add another set right beside it. Let's add two larger curved fangs along the outside, starting on the left, curve out and then down. Bend this out and back up underneath the muzzle. Now we're going to add the lower row of teeth, starting from the bottom, go up and out, and then back down. Now we're going to continue to add some more teeth along the side of the jaw, starting on the left, and we want to go back and forth just to make sure that we balance out our drawing. Just add one more on the outside. Now we're going to add a third row of teeth in the center of the mouth, starting on the left side. Start with a straight line coming down. Connect the bottom with a curve. And we'll add two teeth on either side of that center point, going up and then down. And we'll add one more. Now we're going to add some shape to that eye patch. On the left side, we're just going to curve this up and then down on the inside, just round out the bottom, coming down on the left and right. Let's add a strap on the left side, going out with a straight line, step down and draw that twice, and we'll close off the end. Let's go to the center, add a curve, going up and then down towards the right eye, step down and draw that again. Once we're happy with the layout of our drawing, we're going to go back in with the tip of our pencil and start adding some details. Let's start with the nose. Start with the top edge. Just working our way around. And then with the side edge of our pencil, we're just going to darken up the bottom edge of the nose. And then just fade that out along the top. And we're just adding a fold on the outside of the muzzle. And then we'll layer in the side. We're just adding a little bit more definition and shape to the teeth. I'm just working away along the inside of the lower jaw. I'm going to add a socket along the bottom of the teeth, along the bottom row. And just pull that up towards the top. We're just going to add the inside edge of the gum line in behind the teeth. I'm going to add some cracks across the side of the head, going out towards the cheek. Adding some of those mechanics along the inside of the head, just behind the eye. And then we'll add in some loose wires. We're just gonna layer the back side of the head in behind. Going behind the wires. And the base of the ear. And then coming down in behind the cheek. Now we're gonna go ahead and start darkening up the darkest parts of the head with the side edge of our pencil, starting with the eye patch. And then we'll fill in the inside of the right eye, working our way around the pupil. And we'll fill in the inside of the mouth, working around the teeth. And it'll darken up the mouth along the top, and then just fade that out towards the bottom. So again, just working around the teeth about halfway. And then we'll gradually fade that out towards the bottom. Now we're just going to darken up the back side of the head with a medium shade, working around those wires. And we'll just darken up the top of the gum line, and then just fade that out as we get towards the teeth. Now just adding some shadow from the muzzle on top of the teeth. And just fading that out. And just adding a shadow to the inside edge of the bottom row of teeth. Now the cheeks are going to cast a shadow across the top of the lower jaw. So we're going to start off a little bit darker along the top, and then just fade that out to an even shade along the bottom. Now you want to show that the cheeks curve around the bottom. So we're adding that shadow and just fading that out along the top. Thank you. Now I'm just going to work our way across towards the top of the head, starting with an even shade. And then darkening up the bottom edge of the cheeks. And then just fading that out towards the eyes. And we're just going to go back and add some burn marks and scars across the head. And as we get near the end of our drawing, I'll continue to add some more scars and darken up my shadows. And that's pretty much it. There's a sketch illustration of Phantom Foxy. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. And if you did, please make sure you subscribe because we're posting new lessons every single day. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.